This week on Maker Update, a kazoo with auto-tune, particle goes big, a new spin on the Macropad, a lamp with a twist, and surfing with Neopixels. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool projects makers are making. I hope you're doing well. I have another great show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. On Hackaday, Guy Dupont shares how he updated and electrified a kazoo with built-in auto-tuning for a guaranteed pitch-perfect performance. And I'm going to tell you why this project is much more than a kazoo, but first, let's take a look at what's going on here. To make a kazoo that never plays a wrong note, Guy crammed one with a microphone, an ESP32 microcontroller, a speaker, a battery, charging board, and an amplifier. As you hum into the mouthpiece, the microphone picks up the sound and sends it to the microcontroller. Here, an Arduino-based algorithm called Yin detects the incoming frequency and selects the closest usable pitch within a scale that you determine. But instead of the complicated task of taking your hum and adjusting its pitch in real time like a voice effect, Guy just has it play a synthesized sound at the correct pitch. In this case, it's a simple sawtooth wave sound, which is pretty close to what a kazoo sounds like, really. So at this point, you give Guy props for crossing the finish line on a silly proof of concept, or what might actually be a fun toy. You just call it the auto kazoo and get it out in time for Christmas. But I think there's actually a really cool application here that Guy mentions, but kind of gets lost under the kazoo novelty. What he's also made here is a dead simple, wireless, voice to MIDI interface for musicians. It just happens to be in a kazoo. Because the ESP32 has built-in Bluetooth, it can use the automatic pitch detection algorithm to send MIDI note information wirelessly to your computer. With a songwriting tool like this, you could sing, hum, or beatbox ideas into any MIDI-compatible recording tool and quickly sketch out layers of MIDI instrumentation just using your voice. I think it's a cool idea with a lot of potential for musicians or the musically curious. You can find the schematic and bill of materials on Guy's Hackaday post along with a link to the code in his video description. Now for some news. Particle, a company known for their IoT-optimized ecosystem of microcontrollers, has announced their first single-board computer. The board is called Tachyon. It's priced around $250 retail, and it's expected to ship early next year. There are a lot of Raspberry Pi competitors out there, but the Tachyon really does have some specs that set it apart. The first, for me, is an integrated cellular 5G connection. It's something you'd expect from an IoT company like Particle, of course, but it's a rare sight on a single board computer. There's also a ton of processing power, including an 8-core Qualcomm chip, GPU, and an NPU, or neural processing unit, optimized for intense machine learning applications like computer vision or audio identification. And along with a ton of modern peripheral interfaces, you also get a GPIO header that's designed for Raspberry Pi hat compatibility. So there's a whole playground of add-ons here that are essentially ready to go. More projects. On Adafruit, the Ruiz brothers have a great new guide on how they created the CNC Rotary Macropad. Aside from the Ruiz brothers' expected fit and finish, what sets this Macropad project apart is the inclusion of this glorious oversized dial that works as a precision rotary encoder. This particular encoder sends out 100 pulses per rotation, or 100 distinct clicks along the dial. It's an ideal number for making metric adjustments in CAD or CNC applications. On top of that, you have a dozen NeoPixel backlit mechanical keys that you can assign as hotkeys or macros in your preferred program. It's a cool look, a practical tool, and the step-by-step guide behind it has everything you need to bring it to life. Also on Adafruit, Erin St. Blaine shows how she made this animated NeoPixel floor lamp. There's a ton of fun surprises in this guide, and it seems like it's pretty affordable to pull off. The first surprise here is that she's mounting the LED strip on Hot Wheels racetrack. Chances are you can probably find some of this stuff at a local family yard sale. Give it a coat of paint, and you've got some wide, flexible LED channel. The second surprise is the diffusion. Here, Erin is using inexpensive fake plastic crystals and attaching them with silicone adhesive. It gives the whole thing a kind of geode or rock candy texture that I haven't seen before. And as a final surprise, Erin explains how to trigger different WLED animations using capacitive touch pads made from copper tape. The pads, which she made in the shape of the Adafruit logo, are mounted on the base of the lamp. I think this is a cool trick to keep in mind for all kinds of WLED projects. Finally, at the risk of hitting you with three colorful LED projects in a row, you just have to check out this 3D printed, internally lit surfboard from mosivers on Instructables. He designed the board himself using a freeware program called BoardCAD, and then brought the design into Fusion 360 to create the hexagonal pattern and create channels between each section to prevent water from getting trapped inside. It took 175 hours of printing time and 2.6 kilograms of PETG filament to make the internal structure. Before fiberglassing everything, he added the LEDs, electronics, and batteries, doing what he could to make it all watertight, but still placing valves for water to escape if it got in. The end result looks fantastic, though it sounds like the electronics didn't survive long. Such a cool idea, though. Now for some tips and tools. Just one tip caught my eye this week, a technique really. On Instructables, DIY Machines demonstrates a method for recreating the look of stained glass using 3D printed frames filled with metallic resin. Now, at first glance, I know it's a bit more of a craft project than we typically cover on this show, but I think there are some broader applications here. We're always looking at new and novel ways to diffuse LEDs or create interesting panels or interfaces for our projects. I don't see why a technique like this couldn't be adapted for something like an LED clock face, or embedded with capacitive touch sensors, or even used for wearable LED fashion projects. Within this guide, there's another unadvertised tip on how to pull AI-generated art into Fusion 360 and trace the features you'd like to extrude into solid shapes. Plenty of inspiring ideas here. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we're going to jump over to DigiKey's product discovery channel for unboxing of the Arduino PLC Starter Kit. This is a kit direct from Arduino for anyone interested in learning how to take their Arduino skills into the world of industrial automation. The term PLC stands for Programmable Logic Controller, and it refers to the category of rugged controller typically seen in manufacturing or industrial robotics. Arduino's kit comes with 20 hours of lessons and educational support. To learn more, check out the link in the description. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible. A thanks to TMDC Workshop in Barcelona for hosting me in their amazing space. And thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.